What is up, everyone? We are back with some more Final Fantasy VII Ever Crisis. We got a couple some news and updates here. First, coming soon, returning Crisis Dungeons. So I'm assuming this is going to be because of the addition of the Sea Region. So Southeast Asia. So as of March 20th, Crisis Dungeons with very hard difficulty that were held in the past will return. By challenging the Crisis Dungeons, which are even more difficult than the Criterion Dungeons, you can earn rewards such as Blue Crystals. Score rewards that have already been received in the past cannot be received again. So for most of us, this isn't going to mean anything. But they will be re-adding Mako Reactor Very Hard, Potapilly Sea Cave, Logue's Ruins, and Copine Caverns Very Hard. I think I'd already S-plussed all of those. If not, you know, there's a little bit of blues we could probably get, but I think I've got them all S plus. So, again, this is mainly for our C region people, or those of you who joined in on Steam late. This is a great thing for you guys. For most of us, though, it's not going to do anything. But this is going to run from March 20th to April 30th. The other thing, though, we have our campaign video for week 3, so we're going to check that out. We're going to mute Ever Crisis's volume here and come over here. So let's see what we got here. Let's bring down this volume. Here we go. Let's see what we got for week 3. All right, as of March 6th, yeah, that's nothing new there. Same stuff as usual. All right, we have a half anniversary and event story update. So we'll be getting the next part of the story and, of course, the Glenn and Zach banner. So this will not happen on the 20th. This will happen on the 21st. The rest of the stuff I think should be happening on the 20th, but the Knights of Judgment Project Zero Remnant will be updated. We never did get an EX2, by the way, for the ruin, so maybe that'll come along with some other things. New exchangeable items have been added to the exchange. Collect and exchange them. So you got mithril, gotcha tickets. Again, you should be getting this stuff, guys. There's lots of good stuff in there, so don't be sleeping on that. New draw information. Yep, as of the 20th, Sephiroth and Zach Limit Break draw will be held. So I looked at this earlier, and I'm trying to figure out what's going on with Sephiroth's here. So if you look at the attack, that almost looks like an ice attack, which he's already got ice, and I highly doubt that they would give him another ice outfit, and this is going to be like ice mastery, but he's got ice arcanum. Those of you who have the ice arcanum wouldn't go for this, which unless, again, it's to catch up those that didn't get his ice arcanum outfit. Maybe it's a physical, I don't know. But that looks like an ice attack, and the other thing to note, if you look at the range of that, especially when you compare it to Zach's here in a moment, like that's a wide attack. I mean, this part's pretty concentrated, but the rest of this is super wide. Is this going to be like an AoE attack? And then we got fire here for Zach. Obviously, that's going to be a fire attack, but again, when you compare his attack there, like, that was pretty... Go back just a little bit more. Like, I mean, it's pretty concentrated. It shot forward and hit the target. It's not that wide range there. So obviously Zach's getting a fire. I'm assuming physical fire. Training campaign volume 2. Sephiroth and Zach getting a 200% XP increase, which again for most of us is going to mean anything. Again, I'm assuming this is for our C region people, which again, good for you. Get your guys caught up. Let's get a wallpaper in addition to the mithril ore and the enhancement login bonus this week. It's a pretty slick looking wallpaper there. The luxurious, I think these are the same things as we've had been having, so I don't think any of that's anything new. Hope you're enjoying the half anniversary. So nothing too crazy there again. You know, we already saw the silhouettes. We already knew who that was going to be. So that's nothing crazy there. Next week, though, we get a new event starting and a new chapter release in week 5. Week 6, we don't know. Week 7, we don't know, but we see a picture of the High Wind. So not 100% what that means. And that's it in the realm of news. So nothing else I see has been updated, so we're going to call that one here. So thanks for watching, guys. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think Sephiroth and Zack's weapons are going to be? Physical, magic, elemental, AoE, single, whatever. You know, those of you who are waiting to pull, you know, are you going to possibly go back and pull on the Cloud Glen banner if you don't like... the Cloud Glen banner, if you don't like what the Sephiroth Zack one looks like, are you going to pull on the, you know, what do you think your plans are? And I'm trying to hold off right now on doing anything. I've got some blues sitting in my gifts, but I don't want to pull them because right now I can do 2 pulls and I can clear off these red crystals and get rid of them and I don't have to see them anymore. So that's kind of what I'm looking at right now. But we're going to call that one here. So thanks for watching, guys. Again, if you do like what you see, if you'd like to drop that like, comment, or subscribe if you're not already, that'd be absolutely amazing. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.